Don't worry about how you look every time you look in the mirror. But the Bible says you are fearfully, wonderfully, beautifully made in the image of God. And He loves you just the way you are. Don't kill yourself. Don't hurt yourself. Don't do anything to your body. I know these days we've got people that have done some lip jobs, not job, hip stuff, changing some bums, changing whatever. But the Lord created you the way you are, and for a big, for a nice and awesome purpose. He made you the way you are, just you, unique as the way you are. He loves you so much. Excellent. You are wonderful, awesomely beautified, awesome creature that the Lord has ever created in His own image. Don't worry about how you look every time you look in the mirror. But the Bible says you are fearfully, wonderfully, beautifully made in the image of God. And He loves you just the way you are. Don't kill yourself. Don't hurt yourself. Don't do anything to your body. I know these days we've got people that have done some lip jobs, not job, hip stuff, changing some bums, changing whatever. But the Lord created you the way you are, and for a nice and awesome purpose. He made you the way you are, just you, unique as the way you are. He loves you so much. You are beautiful. You are excellent. You are wonderfully, exquisitely created in the image of God Jehovah. He loves you so much. These days we've got a lot of people that are working on their bodies. They don't like the way they are created. They don't like the way they are. So these days they do surgery, bachinjomona, they do the nose job, the lip job. They want to change up amatoyenta, but we never change. Others are even changing my chin. Others do the boob jobs and whatever. Today, as you watch this video, I just want to encourage you. Maybe most of the times, when you wake up, you go in the mirror. You like looking in the mirror and say, I don't like the way I was created. Why am I black? Why am I so dark? Why didn't I, become a little light? But the Lord created you just the way you are for a greater purpose. He knew why you were born in that family. God knew why you were not born in President Lungu's family. He knew why you were not born in America. He chose you to be born in Zambia. He chose you to be born in that particular family for a nice and awesome purpose. It is time you started appreciating and accepting just the way you are. Accept yourself. Love yourself. Tell yourself, I'm beautiful. Tell yourself, I'm handsome. I'm handsome. Tell yourself, I'm awesome. Tell yourself, every time you wake up, say, I love these man eyes. This girl, this man has got big eyes. Look in the mirror and tell yourself, I love these my big eyes. I love them. When you begin to love yourself just the way you are, you're going to see, you're going to be positive about the stuff that you do, you're going to be positive about everything that you face. But most of the times, we feel so bad. Whatever. We ask ourselves all those questions. The Lord knows and knew why He created you in that manner. Don't feel bad about yourself. When we go in the book of Esther chapter 1 and 2, we are encouraged of how they brought a lot of ladies, virgins in the land. A lot of them were brought. So, yeah, in taste, before going to see the king. It was just one time thing to see the king. So before going to see the king, that one time thing, they were being prepared. In short, they were doing some pedicure stuff, manicure stuff, massaging. They were being fixed, worked on, whatever that you wanted. So if they were that 6 months to be put with perfume and whatever and whatever, could be a pick up, bang a win. And they had another 6 months of just choosing whatever clothes that they would like, shoes, whatever they what they like and whatever. So there were a lot of them, and every one of them had an opportunity to become Mrs. Queen, the queen of this king. So what happened is an opportunity came for them now to start appearing before the king, and everyone would pass. Clothes that way people wear on beach. There are others that just decided to go with just a rapa at tenge, so that in Gabafa Pamfum, but maybe Papunik at tenge or something. The others that did their hair and whatever and whatever. So each and every one of them passed Pamfum, and the king was just not impressed. He was just looking. And the king was not impressed. He was just looking at, okay. But one day, an opportunity came for Esther. And Esther decided to go just the way she is. She knew that she is beautiful, wonderfully, excellently, awesomely created in the image of Jehovah. So how she decided to go with just something decent, and as the clothes covered everywhere, and she had all that, and she had her own natural hair. Tali came out of Brazil, and mama Belinda, and she said, "No, I'll just go the way I am," and that's what she did. And that night, as the king was seated, Esther had an opportunity to pass, and the king just looked and said, "We need sharp sand in our clothes. There's just that uniqueness about this. We need sharp sand in our." The reason why the king had to notice that there's something different about Esther, she chose to go the way she was born. She chose to go just natural as she is. I have to encourage you right now. Maybe you feel so bad that Nishima Bangirong Tari, as a lady, I'm too much torn. I want to encourage you that the Lord created you for a purpose that will be revealed another time. Right now, maybe you may not see the sense of how you were created. You may not see. Ah, am I even going to find good marriage? Am I going to find a good job? Whatever. But I'm here to tell you that God is just unique. Our Father God knows best. He knows best. I'm sure one of the times when President Chiluba the late, before he became the president, I'm sure one or two times he was even told, "Tell me what I can take him. You can't do anything anyway." But he became the president of Zambia at a certain point, you see. So it doesn't matter how tall you are, how short you are, God created you for a certain purpose. It cannot be revealed right away, but one day when it comes and you'll be like, "Wow." So gosh, they say you're in a fear in this manner. That's why the Lord can't trust me to be the way I am. So Esther finally was chosen by the king, and the king was just amazed and had to think, she just went as natural as she was. I'm not going for a camini, for a camini, so that the king would like me. Others very, very concave. I'm not going to ask what's an apautaman and a majority of a shine. Now, quite even me, let me follow suit and also dress up the way others are doing. Let me also do the Jalibus thing. But for Esther, she decided just to go the way she was created. And the king chose her. She became the queen. What is bothering you right now about yourself? Is it family? Is it the country where you are born? Is it the tribe? Is it the street where you are born from? Don't worry about all that. God created you for such a time as that, to be born in that particular family, to be born the way you are. And He knows better. as he knows better, he's going to reveal himself at the end of it all. And you don't know if God was so merciful to change the life of an orphan girl, Esther. And she was an orphan being kept by Mordecai, who was an uncle also, like part-time cousin like that. Then at that time, she was just a slave and she was in a foreign land. But that did not make her to go down or to feel bad. No. As she was an orphan, God had an eye on her. Had an eye on her and just wanted her out of her energy. So you might be feeling bad right now and you just feel like, I can just kill myself. Shout a mom on her and do something. And I don't have money to do a nose job so that I can change this nose. Don't think about all that. You are beautifully, wonderfully, excellently created in the image of Jehovah. And there's just someone out there who loves the same nose that you have. You might be saying, but in addition to this body of mine, maybe you're a lady and you feel like Nishna Kwatile Miefu, why do I have a hairy body and whatever? God created you for such a moment as that one, and He knows it all, He's in control. He cannot allow something to happen without knowing what will happen in the end. The Bible says that I come in the volume of the book, it is written of me. So the volume of the book, it's like it's written of me. Everything that we do, everything that happens in our lives, the Lord has written it down in the book. And there'll be a time when the book will be open, the book of remembrance will be open. So our life, when God knew us before we were born, as we were being knitted in our mother's wombs, the Lord saw us. So as I end this encouragement of today, this inspirational encouragement, I want to tell you what the Bible says in Isaiah 49, starting from 15:16. It says, as the mother who cares for the child that she's breastfeeding cannot forget her child, so I, the Lord, cannot forget you. Even though that mother who has just given birth that child can be able to leave the child or bury the child or throw the child and whatever, because maybe the child has been born maybe without a leg or whatever, then the mother said, you know, I don't like the child, throws the child. But God says, even though a mother can do that, even though it's difficult, but if there are mothers who can do that, God says, me, I cannot do that, because you are inscribed in the palm of my hand. It can be able to see you. So right now, as you are crying and saying, my hair doesn't grow. Even if I put so many cosmetics and the like, my hair doesn't grow. You are inscribed in the palm of God's hand and He sees you. There's a man out there who just loves a lady with short hair. But you start complaining, don't worry, God knows it all. And at the conclusion of that scripture, he says, I cover you with my feathers. I cover you with my wings, just as a chicken wraps up his the cheeks. Now I know I wrap you up. Just to give you a comfort that you are God's precious vessel. You are a chosen generation. You don't need to suicide and die and kill yourself. You don't need to cut yourself and say, no, I don't like the way I look. Listen, you are beautiful. You are excellently, wonderfully, awesomely created in the image of God. Don't you forget that. So, starting from today, every time you wake up, whatever that you were seeing that was, you were thinking like, this is so ugly about my body. Starting from today, when you wake up, when you look in the mirror, just talk to yourself and say, just look at yourself and say, this same hand that looks longer than the other one, I love it. When you begin to tell yourself positive things, you're going to achieve a lot of things and you're going to be feeling good about yourself. Don't give in to the enemy. Don't let the enemy talk you out of, you know, talking good about yourself, because you are beautifully, wonderfully, awesomely created in the image of God. Be blessed.